Sounds like golden jungle. Good luck, mate.
Okay, something a little bit different today. I'm pleased to welcome to our assembly today David Taylor. David recently won a Garvo Award for being the most inspirational individual at their awards evening. Some of you actually may already be aware of David through his music, and I think that perhaps one of the messages that's going to come across today is that our journeys through life, they're not always that smooth, and some of us will experience some difficulties along the way. David is a Newport boy, okay, whose journey is a very, very interesting one, and he's here today to share with you his experiences and to tell you how he turned adversity around. I've not had much time to speak to David, but just in the couple of minutes before you came in, some of the things that he was telling me, I think it may really hit home to some of you. So please listen very, very carefully. And what's happened to say is reflected on his former life and how he's making a positive contribution now to our community in Newport and working with many young people across our city and young people just like you.
Yo guys, just a quick like saying, can you all get involved with me in something, please? I believe that you guys are the future. I don't care what anyone says, you guys, the younger ones, you are all the future. So could you all channel it on with me, please? We are the future.
We are the future.
We are the future. We are the future. They're shy, the younger ones are a bit more on it. Right then, guys, it's going to be hard to fit that in here, but I'm going to try my best. I was born in a very rough childhood, but my mum was in the bed, some very hard drugs, so I won't go into too much detail, but she was a drug addict, and my father was also an alcoholic. When I was born, I was exposed to these hard drugs, drink, violence, and lots of other things. By the time I hit 5 to 6 years old, my mother would take me up town with her, we'd go shoplifting, I would be a little kid, I would run around the shop pretend to get lost. My mum would do laps of the shops, filling her bags up, and I went to the security guard and then she would have gone, oh, there you are, David. But she would fill the bags up and she would have had all the goods. After that, we would go down to Pearl Grandy, she would sell all the stuff, and then we would go into things which can only be known as crack dens. And I'd seen some things in there which she'd abused drugs, people had given these things, and I'd seen some other things which I can't really speak in front of the children, but it was very hard. And at the same time as that, if I went with my mother, I was with my dad in the pub, I'd finish school like you guys. I go straight to the pub and I go home 11 o'clock in the night down in my bed. In between me, my mother, my dad, and my two brothers, there's been 60 years in prison. My mother has spent 25 years in prison. My brother has also spent 25 years in prison. I've been to prison, so has my father. All of my childhood has just been visiting prisons, police knocking the door. Criminality was a normality to me. I can't express how these things are known as being crazy and absurd for people. It was normal for me. So by the time I was a teenager and I'd been kicked out of school, I think I must have been in year 7 or year 8. I think I was like one of the 3 or 4 people in Britain to be given an asshole. I wasn't allowed on Betis High School, Betis Lane, Newport Bus Station, and so many other places I wasn't allowed. There was times I used to carry knives, not because I thought I was hard or I thought that I was going to hurt someone. I felt scared. I was a very scared young boy. And I had that knife, and if someone had hurt me back then, I'm not sure what would have done to me. I'm glad that that never happened at a young age. But that has led to so much crime and violence, hanging around in town. And then that led to jail. The first time I went to prison was for a violent offence. There was a boy who I was involved in having a fight, and I bit the part of his ear off. And I went to prison, and that's exactly what I deserved. There was another time after that I got out a year later. I was involved in an armed robbery. We had an Uzi submachine gun and we robbed someone with it. And it was absolutely disgusting looking back at the night. But back then I thought I was a little bad boy. I thought I was one of the boys and they had a gun. And then we just led and went through that and we went ahead and done that. I'd done about 4 years in prison. Got out of prison after that. I started getting on track slowly. I got back into my boxing. I used to box when I was younger. I was like
When I was in year 7, I was a world champion boxer, but I didn't have much support from my family, so that didn't last as long. And then, as I got into prison, I started to go back into my boxing. My dad was in my corner, and my best friend, and we were travelling, and I'd managed to have my dad in my corner, we're getting my hands raised, and it was also the best feeling I've ever had in my life, and I finally felt that my dad was praying for me, and I felt good to myself for once, and that's been all my positive journey begun. Lately after that, my dad has been diagnosed with pancreatic cancer, and seeing how fast the deteriorated was the most hardest thing I've ever done in my life. I couldn't spend time with him to say goodbye. I couldn't accept that he was dying right until the last 2 days, and he was a very brave man. He took him, was all by his side, and he died. And the day I buried him, I told myself that I was going to drink. I prayed to God, and I said, please don't let me ever drink again. Because all of my family comes from drinking. Like, I cannot handle my drink. I never will be able to handle my drink. So I told myself I'm going to give up drinking. I give up drinking. A month later, I bought this old beat up speaker. I went into town, and I was not a bit as nervous as I am today. I'm a bit nervous, but not too much. I was sat in the town centre, and I said to my mate, you know, record this for me, my first ever time doing it. And he pressed play on the camera, I pressed play. And it came up for about 3 days or something like that. And funny enough, it went up on my birthday as well, just after my dad died, so I was feeling really sad. And they got about 300,000 views, and went on to have 500,000 views. And I was thinking, this ain't even, I don't even need to do this serious, right? There must be something good about this. So I started taking it serious, started busking. I could make really good money from it. I mean, once he busked in town, and people laugh at them or whatever, but I'm coming with something different. I don't see many hip hop busters. So because of all the younger generation, I do really well with it. This has led to me being here today, youth work, and just so many different opportunities. What I want to tell you about myself, guys, is that I've just told you about all the things that I've seen and witnessed in life. With my music, I act like a bit of a bad man and all that, but I choose not to, because I know that you guys listen to this music, and I want to guide you and to show you that there's positive things. And if that's okay, I'd like to perform a quick track for you. It's an anti-bullying track, and that's something I'm well against as well.
Please stand up against bullying. Do not be a bully. No.
nobody likes a bully, scares it. You can't get there, Jack and Militant. You took anything you got to give and proved your resilient. Jackson Cigarette, a different one, the liberal stands rapping on the right side of one of those resilience. The next time that he hits you, remember your sense and said you said true. Chip shop, no confrontation at all, it just kicked off. Sacrifice on the bell, arguing around an armor, hoping it will not get ripped off. Set up an armor, this is a soldier, what kind of man? Chip shop, not get chip off his shoulder. Make sure cares, the beat's over, keeps you calm back, hell, keep your backside on the sofa.
That was an anti-bullying track I recently made, and a comical come through. I'd written a track about some boy called Jack. We met a boy called Jack. He wanted to act in it, and then he started getting bullied just before we had done it, so that went really well at it. I'd like to speak about bullying. I was a bit of a bully in school, definitely. So Joe, one of the lads, one of the boys, and we used to bully people. And then after I got kicked out of school, I used to start hanging around with people who were in their 20s, and I was only about 12, 13. And then I used to get bullied by them. So one thing I will say about bullying, if you are young and you're bullying people, like when you grow up, things will definitely catch up with you, whether bad things might happen in your life or maybe one day you could get bullied. Just think about that individual. You might laugh, some people might be laughing at that track, but the fact is that the kids going home on their own, crying their eyes out because people are bullying them, making jokes about them, or whatever that may be. Also, I want to speak about knife crime. I don't know what everyone's views are on this, but to me, please stay away from any type of knife crime. Please don't think you have to carry a knife. I've been slashed, I've cut my ear off, I've stabbed someone. I've seen my dad been stabbed at like nine different times in his body, his neck, an inch away from his heart. Being 6 years old, sat there, and my nan's living on the floor, watching my dad come on the news. It's just please stay away from it. And also, you'll be 14, 15, you say I come once?
Yeah.
Right, I don't want to be planting any seeds, but I'm confident that some of your friends or some people in here might be thinking it's a good idea to drink, or it might be a good idea to smoke. Please make the most of what you do, because you probably can do all that, guys, when you're older. I'm not saying to smoke, if you go out and enjoy it, because it will become an addiction. It will, 100%, I'll start smoking and drinking and taking drugs at the age of 11. And for me to get over all these battles, guys, it took me so long. Also something I want to speak about is the type of music. I don't know who you all listen to, but I would imagine it's local boys in Newport. And the type of music that you're listening to is promoting these things. It's promoting drugs. It's promoting knife crime. It's promoting girls to be going out and want to go party and stuff like that. It's promoting you to do all these wrong things. If you listen to artists who are speaking about positive things, you will, that will have an impact on your life. Same as if you're listening to negative artists, that's going to have an impact on your life. You might may not think that, but if you're listening to all this garbage in your head 24/7, you will go out and you will act upon it. What are we trying to do? Are we getting those of the youth involved in auditions? We did auditions last month, and we put a show on the Neon on the 22nd of November. It's on the Neon website. It's called the True Blood Event. We're the only event in Newport or South Wales that can guarantee positive music. There is children going to these events as young as 10. There's rappers on the stage like me, acting like a gangster, giving them all this crap and swearing at these children. How is this possible? I do not know. And I'm trying to get this kid like all the clubs. So some of you may not like me in the future, maybe, because these artists that these kids are going to, it should not be under 18 events. So I'm trying to close all that down and bring in some positive music that can be played in front of families and these younger kids. So if anyone would like to get involved, they come and see what it's all about. It's a True Love event on the 22nd of November. I think we just need to get towards time right there, guys. I haven't got my banner with me today, but if any of you want to follow me on Facebook, my name is Misfit Media. On Instagram, my name is MisfitMedia247. And if you would like to subscribe to my YouTube channel, it's Misfit Media. Thank you for your time, guys. It's been a pleasure.